What's this? This is a fuel pump. This is a Pirburg fuel pump. I remember when I did that the last time, maybe 10 years ago, I don't know, maybe more. Anyhow, this pump, it's seized. These are the two screws inside. From these two notches, it goes this plastic here. The older guys are gonna know what I'm doing here, okay? And this one gets movement from the motor. I already cleaned the motor with diesel. It's spinning perfect. There is no problem at all. This is the housing that comes here. This first you have to put like this. You have to put the O-ring down over there. Now, what's my problem? The problem is the two screws here of the supercharger, let us say. It's not a supercharger. It's seized. It's not turning. This because this belongs to a car that's standing. It's not being driven on the road. And now to get a new pump and install it on the car, and then after 10 years you're gonna have the same results, it's not worth it. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna unstuck these two screws that has inside, clean the bore, clean the screws, put back again inside. I'm not gonna be 100%, we're gonna be, let's say, 70%, but it's a natural respirated from 90s, the car. Not from 90s, from 80s. Yeah, from 80s. Anyhow, so when I'm gonna unseize this, I'm gonna start again the camera. I'm doing sometime this, but you know, it's not making sense to get a new pump and keep it for 10 years without anything and then seize again the new pump. Repair this one, start the engine, and everybody happy. Okay, I already open it without a single scratch. That's a good one. You can see here why it became, why it was seized. And that's the housing. All right, let's clean it to be nice and good. I'm gonna change also this O-ring here. Don't have any surprise because it looks tired. Putting it inside, putting on the lathe machine and close this piece to hug here. And let's see if it's gonna work. If it was not working, I'm not gonna spend all of my time here doing this. I'm 110% sure that it's gonna work, that's why I'm doing it. But you're gonna see later on. This is good to make a supercharger for a RC car. Okay, let's go to clean it. After washing it, looking good. Looking beautiful. It's an old school pump, that's why it's gonna work and it's gonna be fine. If it was a new pump, forget it. The bore inside looks beautiful. So now, if I do that, it should just slide inside. Come on, get him with one hand again. So this is slide inside nicely, beautiful. Not bad. Now, how can I close this one? With diesel. Yay. And then petrol. Actually, if you see the petrol that has the car inside, then you'll understand why the pump is stuck. Okay, and the irony. I have one engine. I have outside to put the camshafts on the E-class that I'm still waiting the camshaft, the bolts. That's why I have the housing inside. M157. M156, M156, no, M157, M156, M156, CJX. Yay, how nice. And me, what I'm doing? I'm repairing 30 years old pump. Yeah, I'm doing that because I don't have the parts, that's why. That's the reason why I'm standing by, I'm waiting for the parts. So, to the point, let's put it together. Let's find an O-ring for here up. Down here, I don't care, like I said. Should I clean? I'm gonna clean also this one. I'm gonna clean this at the same time, since I have it out. The motor, I'm not touching it. I operated inside of a diesel and spinning perfectly. It's not sticking or something. We're gonna see that at the end, because I'm gonna work the pump to suck some diesel first. Let's go outside to see where's the old petrol. You have the old petrol from the E-class or you throw it? You throw it?
Yeah.
Okay, no worries, no worries. It was disaster, anyhow. It was smelling like crap, and it was disaster, yeah. So, let's put it together, like I said, and continue. I'm going to wash also this. I don't like it to be like that. It does have any effect or something. The bushing inside is beautiful, it's nice. Same thing here for the axle. The brasses, I have no clue how much brasses has inside. I don't take out the motor because I don't know if I'll be able to pass the brushes inside again. Since working, I'm happy. Continue. Let's see the results. Let's make a test now. Will it run? I have to put my finger here. I'll show you why. If I release my finger, there is nothing to stop this one. So that's why I have to put it back in place. Let's see that again. That's the power supply. So, if there is nothing to stop this screw, this rotor here, it starts jumping out, obviously. Nice! Not bad. This one, this goes up, and this goes down. Let me see, you can see it from the camera? I have no clue if you can see it. Yeah, this is... Yeah, it starts smoking. It's not to get 15 amperes out of that. Anyhow, yeah, let's put back together. Actually, I have to find first an O-ring for here. Let's put it back together, and if it's not leaking from everywhere, if when I put inside it's not leaking from everywhere here, then it's success. All right, now, before I secure this one, will it work? Why I'm saying that? Because here inside it's supposed to have one plastic piece that's missing. It's not in place. One second. If you can see what I'm saying. There's supposed to be one plastic piece that's holding the screw to don't jump out. Now, in this position, it's supposed to work. Let's see. Let's see. Yeah, something's missing. It's turning the pump, it's working, but this one, it came up. 1 second. And now it's eating the housing. Yeah, obviously it's supposed to be down there. That's a big failure. Not bad. I waste 1 hour of my time for no reason. And I put a bet that if I make it upside down, this screw is gonna fall out and I'm not gonna have a movement. Oh boy. Yeah. Let me see if I have another pump like this to see what's missing from there. And you know what's the irony? I found O-ring. I already changed the O-ring. Let me show you. So, I found O-ring, I changed the O-ring, it's nice, doesn't have any problem. But this is scratching, this is supposed to have something like a stop or something. And yeah, I can see where's the shiny mark there inside. And something's definitely broken here. Or can I put something there to stay in place, maybe? Because there are There is one notch from there and one from there, two grooves. Maybe I can put something there to stack it there, and any piece of steel. Let me try. Let me see. Let me see what can I find. Okay. Nice. Not bad. Nice. Let's see now from where we're gonna start leaking. Because okay, it's in place. I rape the housing, literally. Okay. I'll gonna close it and I'll gonna go to test it to see if it will gonna work. The thing is, will it leak? Alright, oh no, don't put it. Let me tell you what's gonna happen. You're gonna pump fuel. You're not gonna have any problem with that. The thing is, it's gonna leak from everywhere.
Yeah.
That's a different story. Yeah, wait.
Wait.
Okay. Now, where are gonna be? Correct. Positive, positive, negative, negative. Probably. Yeah. Yeah, I told you it's gonna work. From the thing is, from where it's leaking. And has the resistance? Yep. Whoop. Oh shit! Yeah, it makes pressure. Yeah, it's working fine. Okay. Yeah. How gonna do that now? I'm holding the terminals. Wait. I'm gonna put the mobile here. Well, you're gonna fill inside the diesel. Most probably not have any problem. It's gonna work.
Why?
The mobile.
Yeah.
Inside the diesel. Anyhow, so start now. I'm gonna see from where it's leaking. No way, it's not leaking?
No.
How? Seriously? Okay, let's test it on the car direct.
Bro, which cylinder head inside?
No, this is 2JZ.
Yo, man.
It's not Mercedes.
That's why you asked me, man.
Yeah, okay, turn it off, it's fine. It's beautiful. What? It's okay. I know it's gonna work, but you know what I was afraid? I changed also the O-ring. It comes here, yeah, the O-ring comes down here, it's not so much high. I'm afraid when I'm closing this, because usually I have to grab it on the lathe with lower RPMs and then with a roller bearing to go and crimp this back. But on the way how I open it, it doesn't make any difference. Anyhow, yeah, we're gonna check it with the petrol, because the petrol is much more thin than the diesel, to see if it's okay. If it's sealing and it's not leaking, whee, amazing. Because this, we have to run the car for how long? Half hour, and then we're gonna storage it for another 10 years. That's it. Let's see. Will it run? Will it not leak? So, the fuel pump back in place, and without even starting the car, it's leaking, obviously. 1 second. That's why we have the bucket down. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put one clamp just to don't explode and come out from the pressure. Again, this is not something we're gonna go on the public road. This is, we just need to start the car for a couple of time, let us say an hour, less than an hour, and then storage again the car. Anyhow, let me put the let me put the clamp and tie it, and then start the car to see how much leak we have and if it stay in place. It's gonna be interesting. Okay, now we have two questions. How much is leaking? If it's leaking like that without pressure, when we start the car, how much is it gonna leak? Will it explode? Okay, so 1 second to stop the grinding sound, and then we're gonna start the car. Omar, are you ready? Let's go a bit back, far away, because we're gonna come on our face. Okay, so make ignition on first.
On.
I don't hear the pump. Off.
On.
On. No, don't hear the pump. It's better get the fuse.
You can start working this one.
Crank. Yeah, it's leaking from everywhere.
you are right, the gas petrol is thin, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I was expecting that. Anyhow, yeah. Crank again to see if we're gonna start. We don't care, we have the bucket down, so what? We're gonna wash also the car. Off! Leave it.
It's raining down?
Yeah, it's raining. I fixed it very good, the pump. It's working excellent. Has an amazing pressure and flow. The only bad thing is that it's not staying inside. Yay, how nice. Anyhow, that's it. That's it. We're gonna connect one pump external to start the car. Or the other pump. Where is the other pump? The other pump is a little bit longer. Yeah, we're gonna connect this pump to start the car. And this one, forget it. At least didn't explode, you know? Something is that. Anyhow, success. Sort of. It makes sense, this one. I lose the clamp, I remove it from that position because it's not clamping properly, equal. And now it does have a leak. Crank it! It has a leak, definitely gonna have a leak. Maybe we're gonna explode now.
Yeah.
Crank! Now maybe we're gonna open, maybe we're gonna. Yeah, start!
Ready, okay, 1 minute.
Yeah. 1 minute, 2 minutes. Is that leaking? Take a look! Without the clamp, it makes sense because it was not pushing equal. Beautiful! Not bad! Wait, let me remove the clamp completely. Omar, start it again and try to keep some RPMs.
Why is it back, bro?
I have no clue, don't ask me why. Maybe the fuel rail or the injectors are glocked. You don't remember how it was a pump inside? 1 second. Try to start again.
Okay.
Start. It's leaking from the fuel line here. It's leaking the fuel filter.
Which petrol is it?
It's not
the new fresh petrol.
It's not leaking the pump. You see how garbage I close it? I put the clamp, turn it off. We have to check the fuel injectors, we have to remove the fuel injectors. I put the clamp for extra safety, you know, don't explode. And what happened? You start leaking from everywhere. I remove the clamp and stop leaking the pump, and it's leaking now the fuel filter from the pipe here. We need to change the pipe. Okay, with the rate of the leak that has, it's fine. Omar, beautiful, success. I'm not expecting that. What are we gonna do? Fuel injectors out. I need it inside the engine room to wash the injectors and see if they spray properly, because most probably they are gone, the injectors. We need to wash it.
Yes,
okay, Nusu. Don't close here. All right. When we finish, we're not gonna close it actually, because the pump is not the best. Just for now, to start the car and leave it running, it's gonna help us instead of getting a new pump. That's it. Not bad. Now, okay, for the end. The pump inside was have some diesel, right? Yeah, so let me start it to hear it how it's running. I don't believe it. Come on, where is it? Take a look at the dragster. Listen to this. Here will be the lifters, but after 10 years, what are you expecting? And the charcoal can solenoid here, it's disconnected. Need to be connected.
Yes.
Nice!
This one was here. This one was here.
Yeah. This was charcoal can.
And I found one piece of line, they put it down and remove it.
Alright.
So just reconnecting. It's working also.
No, it's even to clean the injectors.
Show them is a real E60. So guys, this is one piece of art, because it's a real E60 with the engine number 034. Super rare.
I didn't even say what car is that. You're gonna start the lifters. When it's reached 60 degrees, 67 degrees, the oil temperature, you see it's cold. It's the same thing like the 156 when we started.
Yeah.
This one, the E-Class.
Yes.
That I put the brand new lifters.
Yeah.
For the first 10-15 minutes, it makes a sound, and then you accelerate a little bit and stops. We put new oil inside, original coolant. Not bad. That's it. You remember what I said? It's gonna go away the sound. There is no sound. Beautiful.
No, no need to open any injector.
Huh? No, no, nothing, nothing. This was, you know why? The fuel was garbage inside, what was coming inside. This is from the clutch. That's why, yeah, that's why it's making the sound. It's normal. Maybe it's completely dry, actually. It doesn't have a grease at all inside. What's happening? The pump, I tested with diesel. So some of the diesel was inside the pump. Then you have all this old fuel. Fortunately, the injectors, they're not blocked. Nice. The hydraulic lifters stop the sound and starting direct, eh? See. See that. Now it takes 1 second more, but before it was much faster. Now it takes 1 second more. Put again the air box up, don't fail anything inside. Leave it running, no pressure. Beautiful, excellent. Not bad. The fuel level sensor is not working because most probably it's stuck, like it was stuck the pump. Nice. The stupid this shit, we have to fix it then. You hear the sound?
I can wait 1 minute.
It'll gonna destroy completely. Why? It can be even the water pump, eh?
Start the car.
No. Leave it, maybe it's gonna lock. Maybe it's gonna lock, you're gonna break your hand. Leave it. Leave it, no problem. We make big progress today. We repair also the pump. Okay, that's it.